was here twice in 2018, and I thought that was too indulgent for me to go twice in 1 year. So I thought I'd sit out 2019, and I'd get a ticket for 2020. We all know how well that turned out. 3 years later, I'm finally here. And you can guess where I'm going. Behind me is Splash Mountain, or it was
Splash Mountain.
It is currently undergoing a zippity-doo-dah-dectomy, and it will reopen as the Princess and the Frog ride, because Disney, in their infinite wisdom, have figured out that it's much easier to build a ride on a movie you can sell. And while you're waiting for that ride to reopen, it's always nice to take a poo.
First the wind, and now this.
Hey, this is fun.
Goodness gracious.
This is a new way. I don't think I remember this part of the park before. I've never been off-world before. Oh, I see, everyone's favorite ship. I think this is more my style. I just had a stroll through Galaxy's Edge, and it's very impressive. I didn't actually go on any rides there, but it's very impressive. Behind me is the Submarine Voyage. And one of the very first videos I ever posted on YouTube was a video of me at Disneyland telling you all about how they were building this submarine voyage. And now, there it is. In fact, let's check out the submarine voyage. I'd like to sit down.
Even here, in the shallows, we can see evidence of such geothermal forces constantly at work. You can tell by our
Not many people know this, but if you turn Disneyland upside down, it functions as the world's largest ballpoint pen.
It's Christmas time!
Oh, great! It's 85 degrees out here. In here, where it all began. Oh boy, I think I sprained something on that one.
You were scary Christmas and the haunted New Year. Boo-hoo! Boo-hoo!
If you most of love to socialize,